My name is Chinelu. This is our work area where we build stuffs.
Okay.
Internet of Things, solutions, smart systems, development, embedded systems, and all that. So, here with me is Emeka. She's a web developer, programmer. I work on the web page.
Okay.
So, the product we are presenting to you this day. The fingerprint based voting system. That's the fingerprint based voting system. Then the standalone device that enables voters to do their voting without rigging. As you're voting, the count is actually voting itself on the website. So we're going to start with, we're using the case study of Nigeria, for instance, three parties, PDP, APC, and APGA. So let's power the system. So this is a power bank. I will now power the hardware. So I plug it. It's powered now. You can see it's telling me fingerprint based voting system. PDP is 0, APC 0, APGA is 0. So also if you come to the website, the results is showing 0 also. So the result is showing us that PDP is 0, APC is 0, and APGA is 0. Now, let me register a new voter. I want to register a new voter. I go to admin. This is where the admin login link is hidden. I'm going to click it to open page where you now type in the password and username. So the password is 1234. Then I log in. So when you log in, I'm now like the electoral body. I'm now at Ahiru Jega. Yes. So I can look at the eligible voters so far. These are the people that can vote. These people have registered. So INEC have their credentials. These are their voter IDs and all that. So let's look at registering a new user or a new voter. So I want to register myself. So my ID, I give myself an ID of one. My name is Amaka. My email is Amaka. gmail.com. Then my date of birth is February 23rd, 1991. Okay, let me use 2011. Then state of origin. I'm from Ekiti State. Not from Ekiti State, so. Okay, Ekiti State here. So 090. That's my phone number. Then residential address. Lekki Ajah. Then I put my passport. Yes. So I can now try to register by clicking submit. So the moment I click submit, tells me registration successful. So right now, I've registered successfully. I can go and verify if I actually registered successfully by viewing, going to eligible voters. Let me see if my ID is here. Let me see if my ID is here. That's my ID. ID of one. So it has updated itself. ID of one. Amaka. Amaka. So let's verify if we can vote. If I can now vote. So let's start from the hardware.
I want to vote for a party called PDP. I click on PDP.
I put my fingerprint.
The moment I put my fingerprint, it tells me place your finger. So I'm placing it. So it says vote successfully. PDP is now one. Can you see that? So let's see if it will update on the online server. Let's see if PDP here will become, wow. Can you see that? PDP has incremented to one. Wow, that's cool. Let's test another voter. Even though I used my fingers, I used this finger for a different ID in the registration. But normally it's supposed to be a different person, one finger per person. But let me use it. So I want to vote for APC now. So I click on that. Let me place your finger. Can you see that vote successfully? So let's verify if APC will become one also. Let's see. Wow, APC is now one. That's awesome. Let's try to see if I can vote again. Let me see if I personally can still vote. Let me see. I put my fingerprint again. I want to vote for PDP again. Let's see what the hardware does to somebody that tries to vote twice or more. Let's see what the hardware will say about that. Can you see that? It says, please, you have voted before. Please, you have voted before. It means I cannot vote again. So that's how the system works. So let's verify the ID that actually voted. Remember, I registered with an ID of one. So I'll go to valid votes. I'll go to valid votes. Valid votes. Wow, can you see? I voted for PDP. I voted for PDP. My name is Amaka. Male, can you see that? And my other finger was listed as James. And I actually voted for PDP. I'm ID 3. So the system is very, very, very accurate. So that is how the entire system works. So I believe that in the near future, solutions like this that has to do with a system communicating with a website will continue to spread. We want a situation whereby everything have its location, will have an access to the internet. Your toothbrush should have an access to the internet. Everything about you should have a location, a GPS location, and access to a particular website. So that's the kind of thing we do, Internet of Things.